guy, Sal here. So it seems Samsung is committed to bringing extremely high resolution cameras to smartphones. A few days ago, we talked about how Samsung wants to rival the human eye with a 600 megapixel sensor, but that is at least a few years away. In the shorter term, the company wants to bring smartphones with 250 megapixel cameras. According to insiders, Samsung is done with the research and development of its 150 megapixel sensor, which is scheduled to launch in the second half of the year, probably in a Xiaomi device. Now, Samsung has reportedly started to work on the 250 megapixel sensor, which could be launched next year. Interestingly, this new 250 megapixel camera has a sensor size of 1 inch diagonal. For reference, the Galaxy S20 Ultra's 108 megapixel sensor is 1 by 1.33 inches, which is still considerably smaller than the rumored 1 inch unit. Currently, Huawei P40 Pro series is the one with the largest sensor on a modern phone with a 1 by 1.28 inches of sensor size. As you already know, higher megapixel cameras have a couple of key advantages. The most obvious one is the significantly higher level of details in the image that can be retained while cropping it. The second is the pixel size increases with the binning technology. The higher the pixel size, the more light it captures, resulting in better low-light photography. So it's good that they are committed to bringing higher resolution cameras, but at the same time, it's also important that these higher resolution cameras don't have issues like this, which in the end ruins the whole experience. With the kind of resources Samsung is spending in developing these camera modules, let's hope they also spend the same amount in making the camera post-processing better to take the full advantage of these crazy megapixel numbers. So everyone and even their dogs know at this point that Samsung is the best in the business when it comes to OLEDs for smartphones. But in a very surprising turn of events, Samsung is turning to BOE, which is a Chinese display maker, to make displays for one of the Galaxy S21 variants. This display is said to be 6.67 inches, and on top of that, it's flexible, which would likely make it the Galaxy S21 Plus variant. Because only the Galaxy S and Note variants have flexible displays if you don't count the foldable phones. Samsung has also ordered to make another 6.67 inch OLED panel, but this time with a lower spec Full HD Plus resolution, and I guess it is set for the Galaxy A91. Interestingly, Apple is also rumored to ditch Samsung in favor of BOE for the iPhone 12 displays. Now, there is no explanation as to why Samsung is turning to BOE other than cost-cutting measures. BOE displays are cheaper compared to Samsung displays, so sourcing from them will effectively lower the prices. Another reason I could think of is Samsung sourcing OLED panels from other manufacturers will free up some production space for Samsung display. Due to the ongoing crisis, there could be some potential supply disruptions, so outsourcing would help in overcoming that and in turn would free up some production space. How this is going to affect the display quality remains to be seen, but knowing Samsung, they have the right tools to calibrate these displays, so I don't think people would notice the difference anyway. That being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.